Hello students, welcome to Pragyan tutorial. Myself Bonasi Barua. Today I am going to discuss with you about the Western philosophy of messianism. J.J. Rousseau, the great philosopher, was the main propounder of messianism. Emile, the great book of Rousseau. Now we discuss about the Rousseau's educational philosophy, meaning of education, aims of education, types of education, curriculum, methods of teaching, discipline, and so on. Meaning of education. Education is the development of the child's natural power and ability. There are three sources of education: nature, man, and things. The main principles of naturalism as follows. Natural setting. The essence of naturalistic philosophy of education lies in providing natural environment to the child. It is in this setting that proper development of the child can take place. Child-centeredness. Naturalism gives central position to the child. Accordingly, the teacher should understand child psychology and guide the educand according to his needs and attitudes. Children should be treated as children and not as miniature adult. Child-centered education. Education as the natural development of the child's power and capacities. Negative education in early childhood. Education should be based on child psychology. The role of teacher should be as a guide. Principles of education. It helps to unfold his individuality and personality, that means development of individuality. To develop individuality in natural and spontaneous manner means freedom. No interference with teacher. Self-education. Proper physical training. To become self-dependent, muscular training. Sensory organs are gateway of knowledge, sensory training. Rousseau said that man is born as good, but society corrupts him. Now we discuss the aim of education according to naturalism. Self-expression. Self-expression, not self-realization, is an important aim of naturalistic education. Self-preservation. Education should help the child in self-preservation. It includes self-help along with healthy environment. Fullest development. Naturalism believes that the chief aim of education is the fullest development of the child. Survival of the individual. Naturalism believes that the fittest alone should survive. Education must equip the child to struggle to exist. So, Rousseau says that education aims at the inner faculties, capacities, and powers of the child. Aim of education is not preparation for life, but participation in it. Each stage through which a child passes has a specific aim of education. Naturalism and curriculum. Naturalists do not advocate a fixed curriculum. Curriculum must be child-centered. It gives place for skills and other useful educational activities. It considers literacy subject as useless and gives no place in the curriculum. Curriculum should contain games, sports, physical, culture, biology, physics, nature study, language, history, geography, and other allied subjects. It lays stress on physical education and health training and home science also. So, curriculum for different stages. Infancy. No curriculum. Only physical development. For childhood, learn from experiences and own actions. For boyhood, maths, language, physical science, drawing, carpentry, scientific instrument. Adolescence, religious, moral activities, occupation, sex education, aesthetics, history, physical education. Rousseau's teaching method is through his novel, Emile. Reliance on sensation, experience with nature. Learn directly by using senses to examine the objects in the environment. So, Rousseau said that we should not teach children the sciences but give them a taste for them. Naturalism and method of teaching. Naturalism is a result against the old traditional bookish system of education. Direct experience with nature, things, and men is the keynote of instruction according to naturalists. They follow different methods of teaching according to the interest, capacities, and aptitude of the child. Learning by doing, direct method, heuristic method. Methods of teaching, avoidance of books, heuristic attitude, against rote memory, child-centered education. Now we discuss about the teacher according to naturalism. Teacher should behave sympathetically and affectionately towards the children. Nature, supreme teacher. Teacher, the observer. Understand about child. Teacher, the stage setter. Teacher, the gardener. Role of teacher. Teacher is an observer and facilitator of the child to develop in nature. Teacher facilitates best possible natural environment for promote learning. Naturalism and discipline. Naturalist gives full freedom to the child to perform and learn whatever he likes. No punishment. Full freedom, free society. Naturalists assume that the child has no knowledge of good and bad, but he suffers pain when he makes a mistake and pleasure when he does something right. Thus, he gets reward or punishment for his actions. Discipline. No emphasis on external rigid discipline. Recommended free discipline to child in nature for optimum desired learning. Rousseau's on education. Believes in negative education, learning from nature, education through sensory experiences. Children choose learning experiences. Childhood is a stage in development. Rousseau said that there are two types of education, positive and negative education. We use the term negative learning when stress among students occurs and when knowledge and abilities are not properly developed. We use the term positive learning if motivation is high and active learning occurs. It disposes the child to take the path that will lead him to truth. Thus, negative education to Rousseau does not mean absence of education. It is far from it. Negative education means complete departure from the traditional and artificial system of education imposed upon the child. Negative education consists these things: no habit formation, learning by experience, no formal discipline of teacher, no place for book learning, to lose time wisely, learning by doing, no moral education, no fixed timetable, individual instruction, no formal education, back to nature. Thank you.